pour a glass of craft beer. We can do this. Yeah.
Tell us about your beer story. I feel like people really love to hear that. You've been here a while, so you may be fascinating to see how that went down.
I have a kind of interesting beer story. So it all started in college, actually. And keep doing that. It's going to kill me eventually. You know, in a brewery, there are brewery sounds. You just got to go with it.
That's one of those. Like a bird.
But so my journey into beer started in college. I actually went to college just down the road in Colchester at St. Michael's. And the first time I walked into the Muesli Beverage store, which has become renowned for the place to go for bottles and anything different, I kind of walked in and I was like, there's a lot of stuff. And they're like, oh, that's just all beer. I was like, wait, what? Like, that's a thing? That's all beer? So it was always, you know, you pick up your bulk beer that you were going to consume for most of the night, and then you pick up a six-pack of anything off the shelf. Because it was, all right, let's try that.
Let's try that.
Fortunately, after college, I was taking the summer off. Trying to figure out what the heck to do with my life. I'd worked construction through summers and breaks for the years before that, and it just so happened that Magic Hat was hiring a promotional person where I was living. So I was like, I can do beer promos. Love beer. And managed to execute that pretty well, turned it into a full-time sales job, decided that I really wasn't cut out to work sales at the age of 23, and took a job on the kegging line here, and that was 8.5 years ago that I started on the keg line.
Nice.
Learned the keg line, learned the centrifuge, learned the filter, ran the fermentation room, trained people in the fermentation room for a while, eventually got a lead cellar position, and parlayed it into the head brewing job in November of 13. So
amazing.
It's been a long road of learning and work, but it's been fantastic.
That's great.
Very grateful for a lot of the guys that were here before me that taught me. You know, some of the guys are running some of the other best breweries around the state now. JP over at Von Trapp, Todd, who's working down at Foam and House of Fermentology, Matt is at Fiddlehead, Justin's over at Zero Gravity on Pine Street. We have a couple guys up at 14 Star, a couple guys at Lost Nation. There's Mark, I came up with here at Magic Hat. We started a week apart. Is now running River Roost down in White River Junction.
I heard about that last night.
You know, I've had the joy of working with some really talented brewers that were kind enough to help train me throughout the process. So.
Did you do the 5-gallon homebrew thing at any point, or did you start on the big equipment and learn on the big equipment? Did you go straight to the bike, or were there any training wheels before?
Good question.
One of my roommates was an avid home brewer, and I helped out a little, but I just dove right in.
Sweet.
So, you know, I consider myself the spoiled brat of the brewing industry because I've had the years of working here and training under some really talented guys, but with tools such as, you know, like a digital galvanometer to measure CO2 levels and other stuff. So, it's not something that's lost upon me in terms of the luck I've had getting into the industry and the ability I've had to train with some really great brewers. So, I just dove in. Cool. It's working out. So.
Yeah.